Welcome to World of Warcraft. This is kind of an interlude. We're going to make another character. I'm going to show you a little bit of a different starting zone. Mostly because I want to give you some a feel for how different all the starting zones are. Not all of them are like the Wandering Isle. But I figured that one of the things I didn't do when we started off making our character, the one that we're currently pirating, the pandaren, I didn't talk to you about server types, and that's a sort of oversight, so I'm going to do that very quickly. You will see here that there are different server types. One of them is normal. Another one is PvP. And then we got RP, and we got RP-PvP, right? What those mean is that on normal, you have player versus environment. You can't get into combat unless with another player, unless you designate that you want to get into combat. So it's strictly for you versus the wild. Then we have PvP, which is the next largest contingent of servers that the world is based on, or that Blizzard have. And PvP means player versus player. Now, there are different factions. We've seen the Horde and Alliance, and for the Horde, they own certain bits of land, and the Alliance own certain bits of land. And those are all kind of, they call them faction areas, faction controlled areas. So in those areas, you won't get into PvP unless you initiate it. But outside of those, they've got what they call contested zones. And the contested zone is kind of like a place where the Horde and Alliance are fighting for dominance in that place. And when you're in the contested zone, you will get into combat with opposite players opposite your faction, whether you like it or not. They'll be red, you'll be red to them, and they'll be able to hit you. Then we have RP. RP is role-playing. And there are a subset of people who enjoy playing in the World of Warcraft so much that they've made characters that they can role-play with. And role-playing is basically taking on the character that you made and giving it a personality and giving it a history, and then engaging in other players, engaging with other players to create a kind of a shared story. The final kind of realm that you can have is you can have an RP-PvP realm. That's a role-playing PvP realm. It's it takes the normal RP servers are all role-playing with PvE. RP-PvP tacks on the PvP mindset and the PvP rule set. The other thing that you'll see here is population. There are three kinds of population in World of four kinds of population in World of Warcraft. There's new players, which is where Blizzard thinks you should go if you are a new player. There's low, which means that there aren't a lot of people on that server. Then there's medium. Medium means that there's a fair number of people and you'll be able to get events going and that kind of thing. And then there's high, where usually it's kind of overcrowded in those particular servers. So we're going to pick a normal realm, actually. It'll be easier just to do this. We're going to pick a normal realm kind of at random. It doesn't really matter to me whether or not it has people on it or not, because we're not going to get very far past where we're going, so we're just going to roll on Agmar. And the reason why I want to do this is because I want to show you in particular the worgen and the goblin starting zones, because like the pandaren starting zone, the worgen starting zone is all by itself. You can't get there once you leave it. The goblin starting zone is all by itself. Once you leave it, you can never go there again. So we're going to do the worgen. I'm not going to do a complete worgen playthrough, I don't think, unless people are curious about it. But next week we'll touch on the goblin, assuming we're not high level enough to do anything interesting. But I want to show you these two in particular, because you can't get back to them once you've left them. We're going to make a druid. Now, unlike the pandaren, the worgen are forced into being alliance, because that's where their faction allegiance lies. But they're a little different in the way that you customize them. So with the worgen, what ends up happening is you have a human side and you have a wolf side. If you do something to the human side or the wolf side, the human side will change. Notice over here, he's got... Actually, let's go into the face because it's a little easier to see there. He's got that particular style face. Well, if I change over, he will have a kind of a snarly look here. But if I go up here, there, you can see he's got a very different looking worgen face. And his demeanor will have changed over here. So when you're working with your worgen, there are two things to watch out for. There is the worgen itself and how the worgen looks and how your human looks. So let's pick a fur color for our guy. I kind of like that. We'll go with that. It'd be easier to see his face if he didn't have hair at all, but I can't do that. That's about as close as I can get to no hair and no facial hair. There we go. Okay, let's have a look at the face quickly. He looks dour. Maybe that. Let's just have a look at what the worgen face looks like. Yeah, that's pretty good. I can live with that. That's number 5. Let's remember 5 on the worgen side. Hairstyle. What hairstyle does with a worgen is it actually changes this fluff, the neck ruff. So whenever you work with hairstyle, you're actually just changing the ruff. You're not really changing the hairstyle itself. So let's go and find ourselves a hairstyle on the human that we like. I am not real partial to any of these. Maybe that. Yeah, let's go with that. Hair color. Now, hair color, what it does here is it changes the snout. No? Actually, I don't think it changes anything. It's one of the few things that doesn't. I'm misremembering. That's very good. In that case, we'll just go with dark black. And then we will have facial hair, because facial hair is good. And we'll go with this one, in fact. Okay, so what facial hair does is, as I said earlier, it changes the way the snout looks. So if I go here, and you can see that the ears are changing, he's going to have a very different appearance based on which facial hair you pick. But we're going to pick that one because, as you can see, it gives us a beard. We're going to make our guy, let's call him, we'll call him Lostwolfe. We'll stick with that. Okay, I'm going to show you the opening little cutscene, and then what I'll do is I'm going to set this up so that it isn't crazy to look at, and then we will play this for about 20 minutes, because that's about all the time we have. Off we go.
By their indomitable king, Gen Greymane, the proud citizens of Gilneas once stood with the Alliance against the vile, orcish horde that sought to conquer all of Lordaeron. Gilneas survived, but in the chaotic years following the Second War, the mighty kingdom drew ever inward. Distrustful of their former allies, the Gilneans erected a mighty wall at the borders of their land, closing off their nation and their hearts from an ever-darkening world. Now, many years later, as the seemingly unstoppable undead scourge marches across Lordaeron, human civilization once again teeters on the brink of destruction. As war and terror close in all around them, the citizens of Gilneas are faced with one terrible truth.
Their mighty wall cannot hold back the dead for much longer. And worse, rumors of a new threat have arisen within the kingdom's borders. Of feral, nightmare creatures that walk upright as men, but hunt and howl as wolves.
Stand ready, guards! We don't know how many intruders we're dealing with, but the headlands are overrun, and we're cut off from the harbor towns. Expect to be outnumbered. I want the perimeter secured, and the gates manned by two guards at all times. No one gets in, no one gets out. Protected Gilneas from the Scourge. We protected Gilneas during the Northgate Rebellion. We will protect Gilneas from whatever this new threat may be.
Welcome to this particular area of World of Warcraft, and as you can see, it's a lot darker. So we've got this guy called Prince Gen Greyman, or Liam Greyman, I should say. So we're going to talk to him. What are you still doing here, citizen? Haven't you heard? The city's under complete lockdown. Go see Lieutenant Walden. He'll give you further directions for evacuation. So we need to find Lieutenant Walden, who is not terribly far away. He is, in fact, over here. Where is he? Oh god. I can't see him. He's on my mini-map, but I can't see him. Maybe he is here. No? Alas. Well, this is an auspicious start. Let's try running into the alleyway. Maybe he's in the alleyway. Oh, you know what? I think he actually is. Yes, he is. Well, we're not going to be talking to him about much. Deep claw marks run through the man's corpse. The lieutenant appears to have died from severe wounds. The prince might want to hear this news. You hear the sound of fighting coming from the market. There we go. It's you again. Looks like you're not one to hide or face in the face danger. Very well then. We need you. There are worgen everywhere. There are two quests and we'll take those. Worgen, my father had warned me that Archmage Oracle's creations had run amok. What are they doing? Where are they coming from? I suppose it doesn't matter. Help us make quick work of them. We'll show them what we kill now is made of. You'll give us a cloak, I will take that. Evacuate the merchant's way. The civilians aren't safe here anymore. Not even inside their homes. We're doing our best to stop the worgen from getting into us, but the numbers are too great. Help us by evacuating the civilian homes. My father's army in the prison district will be able to better protect them. And I think I saw... I was right. There is another quest here.
Get gabbing or get going.
Salvage the supplies. Listen, we can't let our supplies get destroyed. With Gilneas walled off from the outside world, we won't last through winter if we lose much more of our stock. Please help salvage what you can, and she will give us a bag. Which is great, we will do that. I will hit the worgen in a minute, because that's extra XP for killing things, but I just want to loot these crates real fast, like. Okay, I saw one over here. Okay, so, to free people from...
Too far away.
Oops. The houses, you just knock on the door. It's coming! Oops. Fight for me. Oh, it's coming right for me. Okay, and this is why I wasn't too worried about, actually going and fighting the worgen, because you will fight them here. as you free people. Sometimes it doesn't always happen that way. Let's see if we can find another house. Amusingly enough, if enough time passes, you can go knock on the same door. Oh goodness. Let's knock on the door one more time.
You need to target something first.
But you are targeting something first. He doesn't want to die. I am now level 2. Okay, so let's go find us some worgen.
I need a target.
Oh, I got a pouch. Oh, I forgot, in this version of the game it auto-equips for you. I'm so used to, from the bad old days when you got a pouch, you'd have to equip it yourself.
I don't have a target.
Okay, we need one more. Okay, so let's turn these in. As soon as I find people to turn them into. I'm gonna run around like a headless chicken. Let's turn this in because it's not really part of our main
thing.
Any
friend of Greymane is a friend of mine.
Have you sold a bunch of the supplies? Yes. Excellent. I'll make sure these are taken to a safe place.
Keep your chin up, eh?
And then Gwen run away. Maybe run away from Gwen. It's no use. They're not getting up. They're not getting up. Good job. Thanks to you, many males will live to see another day. It's time for you to leave. Go to the military district by the Silvernage. Check in with Gwen Armstead when you cross the bridge to southeast. See if everything is okay. I'll stay with the guards and cover the Silvernage retreat. Go now. That is an order. Okay, I'm gonna take this. And we're gonna run. I believe that I have a cape. Good. Navigating this particular city is a little bit of a thing because I don't always remember where everything is. And you only see it once, ever. This is it. Unfortunately, this area, Gilneas, gets kind of problematic. Where's the bridge? Oh. Down this way, probably. I love that. They have all those crows and they go away.
Ain't you a chipper-looking one?
We're all fine, yeah. A little shaken, but alive.
That's enough gabbing for me today.
Okay, and we get a new ability, which is Burn Fire. We'll see that in action soon. The winds know your name, apparently. Most of us made it here alive, but there are worgen on the side of the city as well. We're going to continue heading south once everyone's accounted for. That reminds me, someone was asking about you. It was that Harvest Witch, Celestine. She said the wind spoke your name. You'd best hurry. We're going to need you to get back to the worgen smashing once you've done conversing with nature.
Farewell.
Okay, so the druidic lore is a little bit different from worgen than it is for everyone else. For regular people outside of Gilneas, they pick this up from druid trainers. But inside of Gilneas, they didn't have druids, so they picked up little nature spells, and that became their kind of druidism. We have been blessed today. You are alive and well. We were driven to the edge of extinction once before, but we druids are keepers of the old ways. Oh, we druids, keepers of the old ways, saved our people from famine. When we cut ourselves off from the outside world and our crops failed, it was our orders who called upon the earth's blessings and restored the harvest. Just as our powers restored the crops, your growth in power will develop your connection to our ancient arts. Go develop your powers and use what you learn against the Bloodfang Worgen. Okay, I've already learned Moonfire and I've got to use it against the Bloodfire Worgen. So I've got to find a Bloodfire Worgen, which is probably easy. And I've got to do this. There we go.
I need a target.
Let's go grab that. This is one of the very few times you will see a trainer in the game.
What can I do for you?
Not bad at all. Perhaps there is still hope for the old ways. I've taught you all that is practical for now. It's time we joined with the other survivors. The others mentioned that King Greyman and his royal guard were south of here. We should go there and seek safety in numbers.
Watch your back.
Amusingly, he's just around the corner.
Vorgilneus.
You've done well in coming here. If we Gilneus and the Gilnan stick together, we might yet defeat this terrible enemy. Lord Darius Crowley has been called many things. Rebel, traitor, terrorist. Before this war, I called him friend. I never blamed him for leading an insurrection against me. His land and people were separated from Gilneus by stone wall. But we had no choice. Regardless, Crowley is exactly the type of person we see in now. Enter Stonewood prison and ask Captain Broderick about Crowley's whereabouts. I'd send my own men, but they're still bad blood. Okay, so we have to go and find him. And there is another quest. Yes, there is. This is Lord Godfrey. Check out Lord Godfrey's gear. This is awesome.
What now?
Fine by me if King Greymane wants you to risk your life to rescue a known traitor. Do me a favor and do something useful while you're out there. And kill those cursed fleabags. Okay, I can do that for you. I think that the prison is this way. So Moonfire is a damage over time spell, and the way it works is that you shoot something with the Moonfire, and it sticks to that person for a while. As you can see there, it's got 17 seconds remaining, and as it counts down, it will do incidental damage to them. I keep thinking Moonfire is 3 and I keep hitting 3 by 8. That's really 2. Okay, he is over here. The prison is evidently over here, and I probably have to find my way in from what little I remember of this area. Which is, frankly speaking, not a lot because I did it once or twice. Ah well. There's always worgen to kill.
I don't have a target.
Let's try the other side. Maybe there's bosses here. Although it kind of doesn't look like it. Wait a second. I see a door. And in fact, let's kill this guy. And finish off our quest. Oh, we already had. That's me not paying attention. Hello, Captain.
Glory to Gilneas.
Greyman wants to save Crowley? Has he gotten mad? I don't understand why the king wants to waste time saving his hide, but if you want to risk your life, then be my guest. Crowley and his men are holed up upstairs, probably plotting against the king as we speak.
Keep your enemies in your sights.
Okay. You know what I should do? I should change this. Because then I can actually read. There we go. That's better. This I do remember, though. There are quite a few other people, yeah, I'm actually sort of surprised. Lord Darius Carly.
We do what we must.
Bearman's right. These beasts do not give a damn about our time. Gilnes needs to stand together. One of those mangy flea bags got Dempsey real good. We cannot move until we stabilize the PD. Give us a hand holding back these Mongols. A couple of minutes is all we need, brother. Okay, we need to hold back the worgen. Hopefully he will heal me? Or someone will. Because I remember this being a bit of a problem, as in there were lots of them in different waves. Wow, we're gonna survive for 2 minutes. Is there a timer? Yes, there is. And right about after that, we're going to stop right here.
Need to target something first.
Oh goodness. Yeah, I was remembering rightly, there was a whole lot of them.
I don't have a card.
Yes, you do. You just don't think you do.
Need to target first.
I clicked on Carly by accident.
I don't have a target.
Noticing quickly.
We
did it. Thanks to you, a good man has survived. Listen, for the first time since the Civil War, I agree with Greyman. Now is the time to put us all aside our quarrels. If it sure doesn't look like the beasts care much whether you're a rebel or a royal, send word back to Greyman. My men will join his. There's a safe house not far from here, in Josiah's cellar. My lads stashed some heavy artillery there. Tell our king that my arsenals are now at his disposal. Okay. What we'll do is I'll get us down to King Greyman and then we'll pause there.
Need to target something first.
Go. Assuming you folks want to see more Gilnes, I will keep this character and we will maybe pick this up next week. But that's it for this week. Thank you so much for watching this little interlude from the Pandaren story that we're doing. I appreciate that you're watching and I hope you have a good week. Have a great week, folks. Goodbye.